So we've been talking about Freud's psychoanalytic theory on personality, and we know that he said the unconscious is really powerful in our development of our personality. We've looked at the structure of our personality with the id, the ego, and the superego, and we've looked at defense mechanisms, which are what happens when your ego cannot reconcile the conflict between your id and your superego. So today what we're going to do is we're going to look and see how personality develops. If you remember in our development unit when we talked about Piaget and Kohlberg, and Erik Erikson, they all said we go through stages for development. Freud is also a stage theorist. He says that there are certain stages that we go through, and his stages are called the psychosexual stages. So if you remember when we talked about Erik Erikson, his stages were the trust versus mistrust, initiative versus guilt, identity versus role confusion. He said that at each one of those stages, there's a conflict, initiative versus guilt, and you either come out of that stage successfully or not successfully. And if you come out unsuccessful, then you might have some lingering behavioral consequences from that. Freud is really similar. He also believed that as we go through these stages, there is a conflict that happens. In fact, Erik Erikson came after Freud. He really got his theory from Freud's. Freud's came first. But I just wanted to give that as a reference to where we're at here with stage theory. So there is unresolved conflicts that Freud says. So different from Erik Erikson, Freud says that these conflicts center around our libido. And you may have heard this word before. In our culture, anytime you hear libido, it's usually referenced as someone's sex drive, but it actually is Latin for I desire, and Freud saw it as a life force, one that seeks to avoid pain and gain pleasure. So it would really be represented by our id. And so what Freud says happens is our libido, as we're growing up, travels to different areas of our body that we experience pleasure in, and he called these the erogenous zones. And there are three. The first is your mouth, the second is your anus, and the third is your genital region. And he said that at each one of these stages, again, you can come out successfully or unsuccessfully. And so through your development or through your journey through these erogenous zones, that is how your personality develops. And so he calls this the psychosexual stages of development. And yes, this is kind of where Freud gets just a little weird. So hang tight with me. If anything else, hopefully this will just be an interesting lesson on Freud for you. So real quick before we get into the stages, a term you want to be familiar with is fixation. So when you go through these stages unsuccessfully, Freud says that you can be fixated in a stage. And all that means is that pleasure-seeking libido wants to stay in that stage and won't move on. So, for example, the first stage is called the oral stage. And so he said if you're orally fixated, maybe you were overfed when you were younger, and so now you still require oral pleasure, like you still want to feel pleasure in your mouth, and so maybe you chew gum all the time. Or he would say that this explains why some people smoke cigarettes, as they were orally fixated. So fixations happen if you're either overmet in that stage or your needs are undermet in that stage. So stage one is called the oral stage of psychosexual development, and in this stage, the libido is focused in the mouth. We know this because babies put everything in their mouth. They have the most sensory receptors there, so they feel the most pleasure there. The big events that happen here are nursing, teething, and weaning. And you can fixate in a couple ways in the oral stage. If you are oral aggressive, which means you were nursed too long and you started to develop teeth, you can become pessimistic, suspicious, cynical of people. And if you are oral passive, so you have that type of fixation, you might now overeat, you may smoke, you may chew gum, so you still are requiring pleasure from that stage. After the oral stage, your libido travels to a new erogenous zone, and this is your anus. And Freud acknowledged that being able to go anytime you want to is pleasurable. And so potty training is the big event here because now you have this conflict between your id and your superego. Your superego, society's telling you you gotta hold your poop until you can find a toilet, when your id just wants to go now because that's most pleasurable. And so potty training is a big event in people's personality development. Freud says you can fixate in a couple ways here. You can become anal retentive, which means you're going to retain your feces and you don't want anybody to have it. You don't want to go when your parents want you to go. And so this results in people being really organized and neat and very particular about things because they want to retain it. They don't want anybody to take it from them. So these are people that are like perfectionists, super organized, like has to have it a certain way. We use anal retentive in our society a lot, so you've probably heard that term before. But Freud also said that you could fixate and become anal expulsive, which means you are going to go whenever you want to. You're not going to listen to that super ego. You're going to let your id just poop away, even if it's not socially acceptable. And so these people tend to be super messy, super disorganized, just super chaotic with their life.
All right, hands in the air, vertically. Both arms should be parallel to each other. You, fill this bag with clean, unmarked bills. But first, fix that notepad so it's at a right angle with the corner of your desk.
And tap that pile of receipts against a flat surface so they're not sticking out haphazardly.
You know what? Forget about the money. Everybody grab a broom. We are straightening this place up.
So after the anal stage, your libido travels to a third erogenous zone, and this is your genitals. So this happens when the child is between the ages of 4 and 7, and it's when they first really realize that they have genitals and that they can experience pleasure from them. So this is why you'll notice sometimes little boys just like to hold themselves because it feels good to them. The big things that happen in this stage are called the Oedipus complex and the Electra complex. The Oedipus complex happens for boys and the Electra complex happens for girls. We'll get into that in just a second. You can fixate in this stage as well, and if you do, it will result in you either being egotistic, so kind of full of yourself, or you can have low self-esteem. So let's take a look at the infamous Oedipus complex. This was named after the story of Oedipus Rex, which you might have read in English class, and this is when a man accidentally falls in love with his mother. Freud would say that's not so accidental. So you don't need to write this down. This is just kind of a complicated thing. It's just interesting to know, but how it begins is the boy has the libido bond with the mother because she breastfeeds him and nurses him, and then he learns that he's a boy as well. He recognizes his genitals in this stage, and so he learns then that he's kind of at the same level as his father, who also has the same genitals as him, and so he begins to see the father as competition for that libido bond with the mother. And so during the Oedipus complex, the male child really dislikes the father, maybe wants to get rid of the father, kill the father, worries that the father is going to castrate him. We call this castration anxiety. So eventually, how does this resolve? The boy realizes that, you know, he can't beat out his dad. His dad's bigger than him, and so he might as well join him. And this is the identification stage, and this is when the child, maybe the boy, starts to do things with his dad. So might, you know, work with his dad side by side in construction stuff or outside work, and begins to identify and masculinize with his dad, and then seeks his own sexual partner later in life rather than his mother. So in a gist, the Oedipus complex is essentially when a boy falls in love with his mother when he's young, and then realizes that, you know, he's not going to beat out his dad, so he might as well get over his mom and find his own sexual partner. The same thing happens with girls, and it's called the Electra complex, except for in this way, the girl is jealous of her father, her mother, and her relationship with her father. And so they experience something called penis envy. So boys have castration anxiety. Freud would say girls have penis envy. They believe that their mother has castrated them, and so they have resentment towards the mother, and the girls fall in love with the father, not liking the mother. So boys go through Oedipus complexes, and Freud would say that girls go through the Electra complex. Weird, I know, but this is what he said takes place in the phallic stage. So after that exciting stage, we move on to the latency stage. And if you remember, the word latent means hidden. So in this stage, our libido is actually hidden, which means there is no erogenous zone, which means there can't be any fixation. So this is kind of an easy stage. Everything's hidden. Freud said that we repress our libido during this stage so that we can be successful in things that society wants us to do, like school, for example. This is also the infamous cootie stage. So you are not interested in members of the opposite sex, again, because your libido is hidden. And finally, we get to the last stage, which is called the genital stage. And in this stage, the libido comes back and your erogenous zone is back in your genitals again, just like in the phallic stage. Freud said this is when your sexual interests mature, and how successful you went through the previous four stages determines on how successful you'll be in this stage. So if you left a lot of psychic libido energy at the previous four stages, you might have some issues in this stage. You might develop sexual identity problems. You might develop fetishes. But if you went through those previous four stages, be okay, then you're going to be fine in the genital stage. So in this stage, there's a lot of id and superego conflict between what the correct behavior is. Okay, and just to recap, the purpose of this video is to talk about how Freud says our personality develops, and those were through his psychosexual stages. And there were 5, the oral, anal, phallic, latent, and genital stages. So tomorrow we'll go even deeper into these stages, but I wanted you to get just a little bit of an idea of the things that happen in each of these stages. So I will see you tomorrow.